back with you. Yeah. And apart from that, from like your friends, just plan something, some activity for at least for a weekend. I know the whole year, like weekend, everything, most of activity, homework, many things. But from the next week, as I know, from the like from 13 to like 15, there is a long holiday. So for students, it's really a great thing. From duty to, I guess I am right, for the Ashala Puja. This will be happening in Ankon, Thailand. So there's a national like holiday in Thailand. So for me, I can suggest you can go to the downtown area to see what's like happening about this puja and about the Buddhism culture a little bit. So you will get idea. Just plan an activity with your friends and you will get idea about the culture. And right. for me, as a Konkan in Thailand, I know like if you respect their culture, if you like know about the culture, they will be really happy. They will be loved to like interact with you, like help you. And most importantly, just if you know the viewers like Swadiha and the Kapunka. So it's like initially talk with them, so they will be really happy. Moreover, apart from that, like some people are isolated, they will introvert, they feel shy to speak with anyone, like so they can start with go with apart from the classmate, they can go to the nearby lake that, and apart from the cafe is the best thing, because I mean, like for me, I am like when the college is not open, so I am preferring to go to the nearby cafe to like talk to someone at least, and like and apart from that, just try to interact with anyone, and you can go to the temple as well.
I see.
Yeah, temple is really beautiful. In the campus and outside campus, this all are so beautiful. And I already visited, and like the beauty and the Buddha statue, the decoration, the belief. Everything is so beautiful. So yeah, there's a many things you can go. And apart from that, choose, go for a walk, stroll for like evening or morning, whatever. Right. Like, yeah, just to walk for just for 10 minutes, half hour. Because like when I was like now starting, initially I was like so much busy, like because for initially, like everything is happening with me with the new course and everything. So it's really hard for me to cope up with the situations. So now I started with the go with the like evening and morning stroll. So people now know me. At least they are not talking with me. At least they greet me. Greet me by a smile. Like, okay. Yeah, small gesture is really okay for you to feel better. Uh-huh. That, yeah, you're not alone. People knows you. And yeah, somehow it's give you a chance. So the next, if you're going to talk with them and give a chance to ask many more information with them.
So, I see. Okay. Yeah, I'm so happy that you enjoy so much here.
Yeah, definitely.
You can drive yourself then.
Yeah, well, for sure. That's sure. Like I much not aware about the transport things here. Especially for the downtown area, but so I'm using Grab.
Uh-huh. Okay.
So you can go by yourself anywhere you wanted.
Okay. Now I'm going to Mimadi. You've been to state. How did you feel that? And how do you spend your time, leisure time?
So first thing first, the college or university that I went, they had a lot of activities, like a lot. Mm-hmm. Like you don't even have enough time to join all of them. For example, they have volunteering, they have booths, they have parade, they have clubs, or gym, or sometimes they also have like the trivia night or at the dinner hall. It's so many activities. And I joined the international student club. So like it's always activities in the club. Like every Wednesday, they would have like a meeting. You would come and see each other and talk and play some games and get to know about other countries. So yeah, you get to meet friends, a lot of friends. And other than that, because I was an exchange student, so it would be like other exchange student from other country also. Like for the whole group, we have like 13 people. So we hang out together a lot. We go to downtown, we go to another city, we go to gym together, we go to the swimming pool, or sometimes we go to the bar together. So it's just so many things to enjoy out there. Just don't, as a foreign student, I would suggest that don't keep yourself like alone in your room, because that way you will feel desperate because you are in a new environment, new country, like you don't have friends. So like, don't put yourself in your room, like take yourself outside and then go meet people. There are nice people out there. Yes.
Interesting. What if I am introvert people?
Sorry.
Okay. No. We will keep the question later. Next.
Okay. All right. Thank you. So, as an Andy, have the next questions to ask?
Yeah, there's one question we got. If I'm in the classroom and the lecturer is explaining something and I do not understand him or her because of a language issue, because they speak English the way I do not understand, then what should I do? Should I raise my hand and ask, please, can you repeat that? Or should I stay silent and wait for the class to finish and then ask him afterwards? Or should I ask a fellow student, what did he mean by that? What did she mean by that?
Yeah.
So what do you recommend I do? First of all, I think don't be shy to raise your hand and say, excuse me, lecturer, that part I did not understand. Could you explain in another way? It may put you a bit on the spot, but that is not a bad thing. And if you really don't understand, just ask. And of course, you can do the other things as well. You can ask the lecturer after college, could you explain in a bit more detail? And you can ask your study friends. But the main point is, do not be shy during the college to raise your hand and say, excuse me, lecturer, could you please repeat that in another way? I don't understand. That's good to do.
Okay, so I would like to follow up the Ajahn Henry questions that does Poonam or Miss Mewadi have some technique or some kind of Ajahn Henry technique when you study? I mean, if you don't understand, you suddenly raise your hand and ask, or are you just waiting the class to finish first and then you come to ask? So can you share the study tips to all friends starting for Miss Poonam?
Yeah, for me, like when I'm attending the class, so as a PhD student, we don't have much student, only me and one of my fellow. So for me, I can ask, there's a question, I can ask because teacher are ready to help you. Because if rather than, as my understanding, rather than asking to your fellow or student, because in Thai, like their explanation is different. But if I say something, that deliver is different. And if they say something, we understand something else. So for me, for the clear and transparent communication, is really needed to ask to a chan. And if you don't understand much more on that exact time, so yeah, as a chan suggest, you can ask after the class or at the last of your lecture for answering and questioning. So it's the best.
Okay, thank you. And Miss Mewadi, can you share to your friend?
Did you ever experience such situations that you are in the classroom and the lecturer speaks and you say, what does he mean? Were you ever in a situation like that?
Yes, like absolutely. When I first arrived there, I didn't understand a thing in the class because the professor was speaking so fast, and even though I'm majoring in English, but when I arrived there, I feel like, am I really majoring in English? Because I couldn't understand them. They speak so fast, and the vocabularies are like academic vocabularies. So I struggle a lot at the very first. And what did I do is that I went to my professor and I told them that hi, I am an exchange student from Thailand. My country don't speak English as an official language. English is my second language. So I would like to inform you that I might be a little bit slower than the friends in the class because it takes me time. Sorry. It takes me time to understand. and the professor would understand you, and they would expect less from you. Like, they wouldn't expect you to be like the native student. And when I don't understand in the class, I just write down my question and went to the professor after the class. I don't usually like raise my hand during class. Actually, it's a good thing. It's not a bad thing, but I was quite shy at that time. So I just write down, yeah, and then went to the professor after that. And in my college, they have like learning center, which is a center that help you study. Like when you struggle with any subject, you can just book an appointment and then go there. And they will explain to you, they will help you do your homework. So I made an appointment and I go there a few times. And the last solution is that in my group of friends, like we are 13 people and we did the same class, which is Introduction to American Language and Culture. So before we have an exam, we would like gather together and then study together. So it helps a lot. Like if you know about this topic, you teach your friend. And if you don't know about this topic, you ask your friend to help you. So yeah, that's how I get away with my academic performance.
Yeah, that's good to hear that you have some experience that, you know, it's also have some Thai style a little bit that we would like to ask the questions after the class. But somehow it's good that you have friends up here to share the thing that you don't understand that, which is good. Good learning technique. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so next I would like to ask that as the Thai people, we will have like the thing that you should do or you should not do in Thailand. For example, Thai people will respect the elder people, or we consider the Y as a greeting. So I would like you to share your culture. I mean, as you stay in the US, is there anything that you should do or you should not do in the US? Maybe one or two things to your friends.
I would say start from the basic manner, like the manner that you shouldn't do anywhere in this world. Like, I think, yeah, you can start from that. For a specific thing that you shouldn't do, I would say, in America, like, this is a Thai thing, I guess. Like in America, when they see that you gain weight or you have acne or whatever, they're not gonna tell you, they're not gonna say that in front of you. That's very disrespectful. But while in Thailand, when I was in Thailand, my friend can just come to me, oh, you look fat, did you gain some weight? That's kind of normal in Thailand. But in the US, no, it's not normal at all. It's body shaming, it's very disrespectful. So you shouldn't do that at all. Like, actually they do the opposite thing. Like, even though you gain weight, they don't say about that. They will compliment you about your clothes or your makeup or your hair. Mm-hmm. Like, they give you positive vibe instead of like body shaming you.
I see.
Yeah.
Did you find that out by yourself, or did somebody tell you this?
I actually find it out by myself with my friends.
Okay. I see. Thank you, ha. And maybe I would like to ask Miss Poonam, is there anything that we should do or should not do in your country or in India?
Can you repeat it?
Okay. I would like you to share the culture that what's the thing that we should do or we should not do in India.
Let's say the do's and don'ts. If you are in India, what should you absolutely not do? And what things that you should do? For instance, if in Thailand, if you enter a house, you should take off your shoes. That is the way they do it here. Those things in India, what are the do's and what are the don'ts?
From the India and Thailand, I must say like culture are really mixed, because from the Asian time, as I knew, as study, and I know like from the like 500 BC to here now is really deep connections with the Thailand and India. and the mini culture, food, cloth, everything is matching with the India. And many culture pass from India to here. So like, yeah, for as a tradition, if you're asking, like for respecting. So in like, as a Saudika, we are like folding our hand like this. So in India too, also same culture. Like if you're meeting your elder, respect, you are greeting them like this. And yeah, for the taking shoe off shoes out of your door, yeah, definitely we are also following the same thing. So for me, it's not that much hard to like to get involved in this tradition and to adapting the like culture, because yeah, little bit like for food as like different from, because here is, we are in my place, we are used to eat chapati. So here is really hard for me to eat that. But yeah, apart from that, like should not to do, yeah, should not to do is like every country have like pros and cons and dark sides of that. Like as I found in Thailand also, they are really believe in spirit, because of like, as I found, every house, a great building have their small kind of temple outside their home, for like they believe there is a spirit in this. But I am like not believing this whole thing kind of person. So yeah, for me, like yeah, get involved in a culture, get no culture, but don't believe on that stuff. Because if you're going into these things, that you will get nothing. Because we are here for study, to enjoy yourself and anything, but just go in those things. That's my suggestions for any foreigners.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Okay.
Right. I should hear that. Yes.
Yes. Next will be
This question here is a nice one. Okay. How much time, this one, right?
Yes.
Yeah. How much time should I spend on study, and how much time should I spend on leisure time? I cannot give a concrete answer. What I can say is do not spend all your time studying. Do reserve some time for leisure. You can't study all the time. On the other hand, don't spend too much time on leisure activities. Do also spend some time on study. But many students tend to spend much time on their study and neglect a bit about the leisure time. I would recommend don't do that. Take time to relax, take time to take your mind off your study, go take a walk in the nature outside, or sit at Sitan Lake in the evening, or simple things like that.
Yeah. So sure. The questions that I would like to add up is like, how can you manage your time? I mean, manage your study time and leisure time at the same time to make it like balance. Can you share the tips to our friends, starting from Miss Mewadi?
For me, I think balancing is the key. And I kind of agree with Ajahn Henrik that you shouldn't like study only, you should go and enjoy the world. Like study is still there, but you know, like I think have you ever heard work hard, play hard, or whatever like that? Like yes, it means that yes, that like don't study only, like take yourself out and see what's going on out there. Like, and it also depends on what is your purpose. You might do like study 70% and then activity 30, or activity 30, study, oh, sorry, or activity 70, yeah, and study 30. Because I was an exchange student in the US, and the grade, the GPA wouldn't be count in my home university. So I don't have to worry about that. So I take like activity 80% and academic 20%, and I did a lot of activities because I was an exchange student. My purpose was to exchange American culture and Thai culture, so I joined a lot of activities and did many things, but in the same time I still maintain my academic performance, because I have to maintain like 2.5, and I did get like higher than that. So yeah, I think it depends on you. Like if you are stressed, then with studying, then you should go outside and do some activities.
Yeah, I also agree with that.
You make an important remark also, Mevadi, is that you need to achieve the 2.5 level, the 2.5 points, right? So keep in mind when you study abroad, you reach the level that is set for you. And once you've done enough to do that, then spend some time relaxing and taking your mind off the study. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And what about Ms. Poonam? How can you balance or manage your study time and leisure time at the same time?
For me in Thailand, I don't understand the study culture also so much different from my country and here. So in initial levels, I really found tough for me to cope with the study pattern and all things. So initial level, I would say I didn't go anywhere. I was not going anywhere. And because I don't understand the thing, what's going on? I don't understand thing. I didn't go anywhere, just spending time to understand what they want for me, what I have to write, how to do that things is really tough for me. But yeah, when I got 1-2 friends, so I go with them. So at least for I feel that yes, I want to so much study work. So I'm taking some study part with the cafe. The nearby, we have many cafe, Amazon. You go there and sit there, you can study. So while that activity also, you can study sometime, you can talk with someone. So sometimes it's better idea. And apart from that you think that so much study burden, so at least for a weekend, go out. At least you initially start with your university. University is such a beautiful place. So if you're around, get around for your university, then go to the science park and anything. So it's easy. So now I'm okay. So sometime in a weekend, and especially I'm going to the night market. Really happy to sing to me. So you can go sometime, you will be happy. Especially with the night market. Yeah. Girls. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. And next will be that, okay. Do you recommend that should we learn Thai for you at Poonam? Should you learn Thai before you come to Thailand? I mean, learning the language that you will come here before. Do you think you should know some Thai word before you come here?
Yeah, before coming here, I really don't know anything. Because I don't have any idea. Because in my imagination was if I'm coming here as an international student, so I'm just at least for staff, they can speak English. But when I came here, I found the staff also not that much speaking English. Only few, for international division or as your Achan and especially my advisor, they are speaking English. Apart from that, it's really hard for you to communicate because I'm facing a lot of problems.
And right now, can you say some Thai word like "Sawasdee ka"?
Yeah, many. I learned how many. So if I would like to say, I would like to introduce myself. So I will say that "Di Chan Ben Indiana ka." And Dichan Pen Naksasai Mahavithilai Konken Naka.
Oh, good. Dimak Lai Naka. Your Thai language is very good. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. And for Mevadi, I know that you can speak English already. You speak English very well and you go to US, right? But when you go there, is there any other languages that you face and maybe you will face with some, friends who not just speak English, but maybe they speak another language with you, because they know that US is the multi-cultures and they might speak many languages. So you face many languages. Can you share with us?
Apart from a Thai language, I face some Chinese, Myanmar. Yeah, from the Myanmar, Vietnam. Majorly, many people come from here. Yeah, Indonesia, especially. from if this are student from the different country, you don't need to worry, because initially, because if they're coming, they know they are going to another countries, they have to speak English.
So
you don't feel any kind of like a barrier or something to while talking with them, because they are good in English. Because some students are here to learn a Thai, they are doing in a Thai, so but it's okay, they know English because they're from China and other part of India, so they speak English, so you are good to go with that to communicate with that. Only just problem with the whole localite in Thai, that's it.
Okay. Thank you. And Miss Nevadi, do you agree with Miss Poonam that even though you might face with many languages, but at the end, English is still the center language?
Yeah, I totally agree with that. Especially when you go to the country that they speak English, like USA, England, or Ireland, they speak English. So if you can speak English, then you don't have to worry about communicating with your friends. But if you go to the country that they have their own language, like for example, Thailand, or Japan or Korea, then I think it would be a plus if you learn how to speak their language. Like not like fluently, might be like only some basic sentences that can help you to survive in everyday life. And when I was there, the main language is English, but then as I told you that in my group, there are 13 people from Sweden, Germany, Japan, Taiwan, it's so various. And these friends try to teach me some of the language. So I learned a little bit from them, but I cannot say it in front of you guys right now, because when you learn language from your friend, mostly it's going to be like bad words. So it cannot be used. It's just like for fun.
I see. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you, huh?
Anyway, speaking the language in the country is always helpful. But as Melody said, if you have to follow college in the local language, like for instance, the Thai language, then you really need to speak Thai. If the colleges are given in English, then you really need to speak English, of course. That makes sense. And for the rest, just knowing a few sentences in Thai language, like Poonam said, that's always helpful in, let's say, gaining the hearts of the Thai people. It opens doors.
Okay, next, Akung.
Yes, no, I'm going a little bit so deep, very personal here now. As we are socializing with many people, maybe I just wanted to know, how do you deal with the feeling that may appear when you communicate with your classmate, for instance, or maybe local people, something like that? How can you manage your feelings? It's about maybe dating.
So do you have the direct question would be like, what do you recommend about dating? I mean, should we date with your foreign friends, or do you have some experience with dating with friends when you stay in another country? Yeah.
I think it's more or less a natural question, right? You can't control feelings. You don't go abroad with the purpose of dating, but sometimes.
But maybe it's accidentally.
You meet someone and what do you think? It clicks very well. You can talk about everything, and then should I date or should I not date?
Yeah.
That's a fair question. That's a valid question. So
maybe Mewadi, can you share this issue?
maybe not from your personal standpoint.
Maybe will meet just friends or close friend, or can you share this feeling?
I really like this question, actually, but I cannot give like the 100% answer. So I'm gonna speaking for my opinion and my experience. So I think if someone came to you and you think you can be responsible for yourself, if you can take care of yourself, if you think you are you know, if you think you can take care of yourself, then I think it's totally fine to go out and date that person. Because, I am so excited about this question. So the main point is, if you think you are mature enough and be able to take care of yourself, then it's totally fine to date someone from that country. But my suggestion is that be very careful for who you go with, like for or who you're gonna date with, because it's a foreign country. You don't know those people and they are totally stranger and you are new. So just be careful and bear with that. But I would say, yeah, if it happened, then let it happen. If someone came to you, then just enjoy them. Maybe your soulmate is there in that country, because you fly across the world. If it happened, then it's maybe your soulmate. And it also happened to me. I don't know if he's my soulmate, but we are dating right now, and I met him there, and we are still talking now today. So I think it depends on you, but be careful with those people.
Thank you for sharing. Be a bit
realistic in the expectations also. I mean, if you are abroad, you know that after so many months, one semester or two semesters or a limited amount of time, you will go back to your own country. So if you date, then keep that in mind. It may not be forever.
Yeah.
Well, maybe the very.
And I think it also depends on you to define the limit or define the love. Maybe you're happy to be like just friend. You're happy to be just close friend. You're happy that okay, if one day you go back and you guys still keep talking. I think it depends on people. Eventually, love is, you know, cannot define.
Cannot be.
It's beautiful. Yeah. Even though at the end you will broke up and then okay, you still be friend. Yeah.
Every experience.
Yeah.
And I think it's also a way that you can learn new culture from your boyfriend. It's a
culture that you
cannot experience in daily life. It's very special.
Okay.
Thank you. Can we invite any other maybe international students? What do you think about this?
You're asking Poonam,
I'm asking the international students who are on online at the moment joining this meeting.
Someone would like to share this. Maybe Meiti, can you share what you think about for, you know, dating with friends when you go to another country?
Dating? Well, I think in terms of friendship, I would say it is very good, you know, not only improving your English skill, but I'm thinking about the sensitivity of cultures, because, you know, when you go with the native people or, you know, for example, my case, I've never been outside Thailand before, but I'm fortunate to take care of so many international students from around the world. And yeah, sometimes they just act like, because they are strangers here, you know? And yeah, the things that they don't really know that how to do. So as a native here, I think it's just a good host to just tell what you can do and what you cannot do. And I think at the same way, if I go to somewhere else, I think, yeah, the native people are going to be very helpful. And this is good to know the culture, I would say. Yep.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, we will move for next question. Maybe one or two more questions, Ajahn Henry.
The question I have, we got back from you is, can I work or can I volunteer? Well, I'm a student in Thailand. Answer is volunteering is usually possible. Work is less easy, because normally for work you would need a work permit and you need to apply for a work permit at the city hall. Otherwise you are not allowed to work. But volunteering is always possible. There are quite a number of volunteering projects if you look around a bit. So yes, you can spend your time volunteering. volunteering would also look good on your CV, because it's a social activity, it's helping the community and so yeah, feel free to.
Yeah, so Ms. Poonam, have you joined as volunteer here in KKU?
For now, as of no, because of projects and something is not happening right now, but now the sessions are open now, so might be I get a chance to get engaged with any as a voluntary to join any kind of project or something, because of like as a student, might be I can join some NGO because they are doing some kind of activities in downtown area and some culture activities. So I would love to.
Yeah, and if IAD has some activity, we will let you know. Maybe you can join us for a volunteer.
Thank you so much.
Okay, and Mevadi Ka, have you joined as a volunteer when you went to exchange program?
Actually, volunteering is a part of my program. I have to do 20 hours of volunteering. So yes, I have done the volunteer. I went to many volunteering, like at the blood drive to help assist people who come to donate blood, or go to church and do the cleaning, or even go to the creek to collect like the water to be example for the scientists and things like that. It's so many volunteering activities in the US. And I think it's so easy to see what activities do they have, because they will have like a portal of the activity list, so you can just like click and then register and then you can join them. Even though that college is like a lot smaller than Konkan University, but so many activities, so many volunteering.
Okay, I see that you have some experience to join your volunteer program when you study there. And I think that the US quite give the important for the volunteer activity a lot, right?
Yeah.
Yes, it's good that if you get some chance to join the volunteer, and then you will, you know, like Ajahn Hendrik said, mm-hmm. you can put to your CV and that is really related to your job application in the future. Yeah, okay. All right, I think that is for our speaking
interview.
Session.
Yeah.
Yeah, the interview session. So thank you so much, Ms. Mevadi and Ms. Poonam, for joining us this session. And actually, we would like you to stay until the end, right? Okay, Apung, what was going to have for the next session?
Oh, before we go to the next session, I forgot to share the video
Mevadi,
right?
Video. Okay.
Okay, allow me to share it. Is there any sound? The sound is there. Once upon a younger year, when all our shadows... Sorry. I forgot to share the sound. Okay. When all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me.
pouring down, light a fire they can't put out. Carve your name into those shining stars. He said go venture far beyond the shores. Don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. When I was just a kid, I heard him say, he said one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights that never die. My father told me.
Okay.
It was an extremely entertaining video that you made,
such Melody. A lovely video.
Lovely video.
Yeah, Melody, you went to many places and, you know, the activity that you have done looks so fun. And I can feel that you're happy. You're happy when you were there. Yeah.
I was so enjoy and I was so happy. So I want to share these memories to international students here that like go explore the world. It's so many things out there, so many fun things to do. Hope I can inspire some of you here.
Yeah. So maybe next time we would like to invite you to come and, you know, give some technique how to apply the scholarship to your nong later. Naka. Okay. All right, Akum, what's next?
Now is the turn for IAD hours question, actually. But then we haven't had any question from our registration form. Maybe if I give the floors for everyone here who want to ask some things, is please.
Yes, if you have some questions to ask now, you can raise the issue or you can type on the chat, and our staff and our friends so happy to share the answer.
Yes,
questions already chat.
If someone would like to ask, okay. And Pimon also here to answer every question.
Right, if you want to know how to anything related to your study here in Konkan, feel free to ask them. If there is any question, not yet. Okay, let us think maybe.
Ajahn Hendrik, Akum, what about a question from the registration? Do we have?
No, we don't have any question.
Oh, just general.
Yeah, mm-hmm. We just have. We just have a statement here that I have no problem about living in KKU, but I want some friends and place to improve my English.
Yeah, maybe you can start from this question.
I guess this one might from Thai student, right?
Yes.
And as today we have many foreign friends, I would like you to introduce yourself to Thai friends. Maybe start from Jing Xian Yun, Chinese student, right? Are you there, Jing Xian Yun? Well, it's okay. Maybe Rina.
Yes.
Rina.
Hi, Rina. Can you introduce yourself to your friends? So maybe they will know you and can be your friends after this session. Yes.
Okay. Hello, My name is Yakanda from Japan.
Oh, Japanese?
Japanese.
Ah, okay. Nice to meet you. Next, Siramanirat is the Thai student.
Yes.
Ika. Ka. Nanamtoy hai pun rujakreka in English.
Hello. My name is Ramanirat. I am the fourth year Kyuso student from KKU.
Okay, nice to meet you, Ka Sira. Next will be Wong Nian Dang. Hi.
Hi, everyone.
If for those, if you have a camera, then I turn your camera on. It makes it a bit personal, more personal. Hi, yeah, that's fine.
Hi, everyone. My name is Wong Nian. Now I am the PhD nursing student here. I come from Vietnam. Nice to meet you all.
Nice to meet you too.
Nice to meet you too.
Maybe next, who's that? Pui Mei Li. Sawasdee krap, Pui Mei Li.
Yes, good morning. I am Mei Li, come from Cambodia. I am a master student in the Faculty of Pharmaceutical Science. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
If I can ask just one question, if you could ask one question about living as a foreign student at KKU, what would the question be? Do you have a question in mind right now?
Not yet.
About studying, about language issues, about free time, how to spend your free time, what would you like to do? Do you have the opportunity? Do you know who to contact? Things like that.
Yes, I got a lot of information from my Cindy and my friend, mm-hmm. So that's not really a concern for me.
Okay, so generally you are happy at the moment.
Yes.
Oh, that's good.
Thank you so much.
That's good.
Okay.
Next you. One.
Tin Pipe.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Oh. Hi, Tin.
Yeah, and I
we meet
saw...
again. Yeah, hi there.
Nice to meet you. I am PhD student also, and I want to share in this session, Poonen and I try to dating with a Thai boyfriend. So I use a Facebook dating app, but it's difficult to get a boyfriend because we don't understand the Thai language and they don't understand the English language. And I want to be a friend or you. So Poonen and I always stay in the study area. So and sometimes you can meet complete and then you can greet in with me, and because I want to be friends or international friends. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Take it as it comes. Just take it as it comes. Usually if you are looking for something, then you don't find it. And the best things that happen in life are usually the things that are not pre-planned in advance. They just happen to you. So,
yeah.
Anyway, I wish you luck. I hope you succeed in what you want. Would be nice.
Yeah, me too. Wish you luck, Naka.
Yeah, I want to be a facilitating. Yeah. I want to be happy. I want to be the gotcha about relationships and married life, especially timekeeper. Yeah, just to be fan.
Even if in a foreign language, that would be some sort of a threshold. Because if you don't speak each other's language, then you need to work a way around that. So either learn each other's language, so you have to learn Thai, or he has to learn Vietnamese.
Open your mind.
And
thank you for sharing with us. Maybe we move to another student.
Wait, Poonam is raising hand.
Oh, Poonam. Okay, you can continue. You can continue the conversation, ka.
Yes,
sir. Is there any clarification?
No, actually, Indian is really right. It's really hard to get, like, at least for a friend also, it's really hard because they don't like to, because they are facing problem due to the language, so they are not easy or they will not get your friend easily. So, as Thai friend, I don't have any kind of, but yeah, I can talk with them. So, thinking is
okay.
Facing problem during if you want to date someone, still you can't, because as everybody knows that many culture like that, many boys like boys, girls like girls, it's really hard to date someone.
And, okay.
Yeah, my question is that basically I'm just coming everybody's I'd be not related to this. But when I am experienced over here, if I'm going to sometime night market or something, buses are really running for a short time, at least for a night or something. Sometimes it's really hard to get the bus. So there is a chance to be here, extending the time, something around 10 at least. I am concerned about the time, because when I'm going to Indian and Sue and we are going together for the market, so, you know, the girls getting a time to a shopping something. So, it's around 9, if 8 or 9 something, you not get a bus. So, it's really hard for students. Not only for the shopping. Another thing, it's no concern.
Yeah, I see. Okay, Funa. Glad to hear that.
Thanks for sharing the story with us. Okay, maybe we asked Thai student to introduce yourself. Chonnawit ใช่ไหมคะ Chonnawit
ครับ
ครับ could you please introduce yourself to your foreign friends?
วิ
น้องชนวิทย์ยังอยู่ไหมคะ
รีบเลย
อ้าวไม่เป็นไร we still have more พัฒนันค่ะน้องพัฒนันคะชนวิท connecting พัฒนา you can start first
okay hello my name is Pakunan Kankein and you can call me Pin I'm a student in humanities and social sciences in English for third year student thank you
okay nice
would you be looking forward to connect with foreign students to join activities with foreign students
Yes, absolutely, yes. Yeah, I want to have more friends. I mean, foreign friends.
Okay, then. Well, this is a good start, introducing yourself. Thank you.
Okay, and nice to meet you, นะคะ น้อง พัฒนัน. And next, I will move to น้อง ชนวิทย์. Okay, ชนวิทย์, can you introduce yourself? Maybe he cannot hear us. Okay, ไม่เป็นไร, ไม่เป็นไร. So, yeah, this is I guess that you guys knowing each other already, but if you guys would like to connect each other more, maybe I suggest you to, how to recommend the Facebook page, ไหมคะ พี่อากุง, to be the corner, the center for the student.
We have the Facebook page, KKU International Students. Join the group. We post frequent things, and if you are looking for activities, if you are a Thai student and would like to join activities with foreign students, just post on the Facebook page. If you are a foreign student and you would like to join some activities with Thai students, do the same thing. Just post a message on the Facebook page. Wherever IAD can facilitate, we will do that. So we read all the posts that are posted and we'll try to help you as best we can.
Yes, it's when you join the group and then you can find your friends after that. Yes.
Or even if you post on the Facebook page and there are some things of joint interest that you say, hey, he or she has the same issue as I have. So then you can talk together through Messenger, privately to each other also.
Okay. Yeah. I think that's enough for this session. And next, for the last session, we will move to game.
Yay! Game. So anyone, please get ready because we have something. What is it?
Language. English okay. language. And today we are so lucky that we have our Thai student come and help us, which is Nong Meti. Nong Meti will be the one who lead the game and let's everyone join and have fun together. Okay, Meti, are you still there?
Yes, I couldn't be more ready. So, and yes, I thank you so much for having me once again. And how about you, Nuna Tassini? Are you here?
Tassini, you still awake?
Yes.
So we're going to work together and we have been preparing the Kahoot for, you know, a week for you guys for today. Okay, I'm not going to waste your time. So let me share my screen, please. Okay, here, gonna start Kahoot for everyone. Okay, if anyone has you know, another thing than your computer, you can use your smartphone and enjoy this session. Please.
Okay, everyone, please join the Kahoot. You can scan or get the pin to start the game.
Can I join them?
ได้ค่ะ everyone can join
everyone can join here.
Thank you ค่ะ
yeah, we have two right now, but don't take it seriously. Just, you know, in the past semester I studied global English and yeah, this is a good things to know about Tinglish, which is Thai plus English. So yeah, as a foreigner or international student, I think it's gonna be like benefit for you guys. Okay, we have 7 people here.
We need more 10 people or 9 people.
Yes, maybe. 7.
So today's game is about the English language.
Oh yeah, sorry, we have 2 parts. Yes, it's all about English, but the first thing is Tinglish. But the second thing is basic English for traveling, which is, yeah, be fair about FIFA also. So we have 7 people, there's another people.
Is this only 7 people? I think we have more, Naka.
Or we have more.
Okay, maybe let's counting.
Let's count.
Okay, are you set to count? 10, 9, 8,
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay, maybe I think. Is it
wait.
Akung. Akung wanna join.
Okay. No, maybe the student, the participant doesn't know the what do we call it, the prize or the reward.
Oh, like we this. Have the reward. I forget to tell.
Top
3, top 5, na here, Akung. Top 3.
Oh yeah.
Top 3
people who are the winners will gain the gift from IAD. And if you are the winner, you can come to receive the gift with us again at our office.
Okay. Maybe yes, we got 7.
Okay, we have 7 people here. Okay, let's see what it's gonna look like.
Okay.
So am I in?
Same.
You hear that quite a lot.
Icons.
You have to keep. Mai, you join my phone.
Right? Oh, yes. Thai people love to say the same word. Yeah, the same, same, which is similar. So just similar, but similar, similar, which is, yeah, the same meaning. So, yeah. Next. Oh, pin, not the first one.
Pin. Next question.
Check bill.
So, คนไทย like to say check bin, check bin, check bin.
Yeah. Yes, actually, the meaning of check bill means be
peaceful. Yes, correct.
Wow.
Open the light, open the light.
Open the light.
Perfect, perfect.
Okay, this is the tough one, I would say, because the open, the word open in Thai, like we have like only one meaning. So it could be turn on or could maybe open, because in Thailand we use only bird.
Thai, so, it's like normally we like to direct translate.
Yeah.
Meaning.
Yeah.
So we would say open the light on, but actually in a correct way, we would say turn on the light.
Yeah.
Yeah, like Nong Meiti said.
Woo, Meva.
Meva. I have beautiful. Chan suai. Chan suai.
Oh, yeah. This is kind of complicated, because Thai people always have a problem with part of speech. I would say, yeah, when they see I have a beauty, or I am beautiful, they're gonna say I have beautiful.
Yeah, yeah, but incorrect way we just say I'm beautiful.
I'm beautiful. Yeah. Yes.
Thank you. Oh,
ask me.
I'm boring.
Oh yeah,
yeah, correct.
In English grammar, right, you know, even though like for many people who studying for English so many years still using wrong. Yeah, I'm boring, but actually I'm bored. Yeah, so. Still Mabel. I send you effort.
How to say incorrect way.
Oh yeah. Yeah, you guys are master. Yes, the correct is I will take you to the
airport. I will take you to the airport. Is there another phrase, Ajahn Henry?
There's one phrase I also often hear, and that is no have.
No have.
Maybe.
It's a way if it's the way the Thai people say. If you ask them, do you have this? Do you have that? Maybe. I don't have it. But okay. When Thai speak English, they like to translate as no have.
Chai. Okay, next please. I used to go to Phuket. How to say in the grammatical way? Yeah, correct. Very good, everyone.
Yes, you guys are good at grammar. Oh, still main one.
I will see you tomorrow, na.
Now, what does na mean?
Nah,
I will see you tomorrow. Nah,
oh, yeah, yeah. I guess tomorrow. You got ties already, because you know, I even as a Thai person, I cannot really. When all my foreigner friends ask me what nah mean, that
Yeah, it's like Thai people like to add the ending word, like na, na ka, na krap, right?
Yeah.
You know, it's just always style to say that. You might probably heard na, na ka after the sentence a lot in Thailand.
Yeah. Especially men always used to say krap, krap after at the end of every sentence. Women say ka, although women say ka more than that men say krap, I think.
Yeah.
But still, yes. it's doesn't really mean anything. It's just a polite way of ending a sentence. So, see you tomorrow, Na.
Okay, next. Sue Asmi. Are you hot? What does this mean?
Yeah, there is nothing wrong about are you hot, because if you understand it, are you popular? That is because this is the way for English speaker gonna understand. But it's actually, you know, Thai people just use about our grammar, which is referred to, is this hot here? Is this hot? Or something like that, yeah.
So as a foreigner, you can misunderstand, right? If somebody says to you, I am hot.
Yeah.
What they mean to say, I'm Chandran, I'm warm, it is hot here.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the other thing, what do they say? I'm hot, I'm popular, I'm sexy, I'm... No. Just warm. I'm just feeling warm.
Okay.
Feeling warm, yeah. Okay.
The next.
Ta-da! I eat already. How to say in a correct way?
Yeah. Yeah, already. Because in Thailand, in Thai language or Asian language in general, we have no tense. And we just put the adverb to show that, oh, this is part of something. We use the word leo. Leo, yeah, finishes. But so, yeah, even though we talk about the past time, people, you know, we have a problem about conjugation also. Not eating, but eat. Like, even though you have eaten, we just do eat.
Eat.
Yeah. Right. Okay. This is for this section.
Number three.
May.
We do.
And the winner of this session, May YUS.
Yeah, May.
Okay.
Congrats, na kha, May wa.
Okay,
congrats also to Mayna and Wang Nguyen Da. I hope I pronounce it right.
So I would like to give my prize to the fourth student that got the answer. I saw Kun something. Like, I will not get the prize, just give it to.
Thank you, Ka. So, because actually you were our internship, right? Yeah. Thank you.
And the fourth one, right, Ava? What do you mean?
So you will switch to number four, right? So who's got this score?
Who is number four?
Ask me.
Oh, ask me. Ah, okay. Ask me, you can come to receive the gift with us.
Yeah.
At the IAD office.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
So three of us, right? Me.
Okay. I still have another Kahoot.
Oh, another Kahoot.
Real quick. Okay.
This one is about easy English, and the vocabulary is about the travel, the hotel, and the airport. It's like the word that you might face when you go to travel. So this quiz gonna be very easy. We're gonna provide you the definition and let you guess that what that is mean.
Oh, you need to
welcome
me. Hey, how do I do this?
We have only four. Maybar, you wanna talk again?
Of course, give me a second.
Okay, we still need more people to join. Now we have 4 people. I have beautiful da. Who is that? The name.
I have beautiful.
Okay, I think that's enough. You can start now.
Yep.
To arrange to stay in a hotel. What's that? What's that word? Ding.
Ding.
Everybody correct.
Yeah.
Just
book.
Book. Yeah. Book a hotel, book a room. Yes.
Another word, reserve. Reserve.
Yeah.
Reserve is a more formal word.
Yeah, it's more formal word. Okay, I have beautiful. A large area near the reception. Mm-hmm. Garden, Mike.
Yes.
Yeah. Everyone, oh, great.
Lobby.
Ding. Next, a male worker at a hotel who carry luggage.
Ding. Oh yeah, we call a bellboy.
A long empty space that you walk down.
Yes, we call yes. Eyes. Right?
We have a very international group of participants.
Thank you.
Woo. Pin, yeah.
Pin. A person who held the captain fly the plane. Okay. How to call this word? Yeah, yep.
The
correct.
Co-pilot.
The co-pilot.
Oh, still not been.
The action of register one's person typically as a passenger at an airport. Okay.
Oh yeah, we call this check-in. To check-in.
Check-in.
Check-in. Usually at an airplane, you check in the flight.
A short journey or trip, especially when taking as a leisure activity. How to call this word?
Yes, I think this one is a little bit harder for someone to not, you know, get into the vocabulary. Yeah, but we call the short break, the short journey or trip.
Yeah. Anthony, can you explain more about the excursion?
I think formally the word exploring is a verb, excursion is a noun. And it says the short journey or trip, so it must be a noun. So that's why excursion is the better description. Yeah. Exploring is good because what you do during a short journey is exploring. So the word in itself is good, but the better choice in this case is excursion.
Okay.
Oh.
The ticket which gives you permission to enter the plane. Yeah.
Yep. Everybody. One passport. Again, you do need a passport, no doubt about that. But the actual document that allows you on the plane is the boarding pass.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. Two more.
When the airplane will not leave at the correct time, how can we call that?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, delay.
The flies is delayed.
Delayed, yeah.
Rule two.
Too far.
Last, but certainly not dates.
Journey that stay inside the same country. Hometown.
Yes, you guys. Yeah,
domestic journey.
The winner is
number three. Okay.
Suddenly number three. Number two. Number one is.
Ta-da. Ashmi.
Okay, ka. Congratulations to Ashmi again. But actually, Ashmi got one gift already. I want to switch to the number four, ka. Number four student. Number four, ka.
Okay. Maybe May.
May. Nong May.
Okay, let's check. It's gonna be here. Oh, Pin, Nong Pin, sorry.
Pin, okay. Nong Pin, you can come to receive the gift with us at IAD office, na ka. And also Tiwa, Ajahn Hendik, mai tong ao. Okay.
Bye-bye.
Thank you so much, ka, Nong Meti. And thank you everyone for joining the game with us. I guess that, yeah, you know, the Tinglish is like the English language that Thai people actually use or say here. So I guess that you might familiar or heard our sentence or phrase like this, but you know, it's normal when you go to another place, you will face with some kind of, you know, the dialect same. Language combined with the standard language. Yeah, so just feel happy and absorb with that, nakha. And also, of course, when you go travel, you might face the easy vocabulary that we just play. Yeah, so just, you know, keep in mind that it's easy to use and don't confuse about that.
and see the fun of it. If a Frenchman speaks English, he will speak it in a different way from an Englishman. An Englishman would say, "Hello, how are you doing?" A Frenchman would say, "Hello, how are you doing?" Or an Italian. So you see, the sound of the language is different, but it's still understandable. You know exactly what he means. Something else. I think that the Thai like to put the emphasis on the last syllable. University, strawberry,
history.
History. Yeah. The English language would say history, strawberry, university. But that's the fun of exploring different languages in different worlds, I think.
But you know, at the end, it's like English is still the central language, the international language that people use around the world. Even though you might speak with a different tonation, pronunciation, but at the end, English is still the central language that connect people or use for communicate. At the end, people still understand what you try to say, what you try to communicate.
Absolutely.
Okay. So. All right. So I guess today is enough for today, right, Agung?
Yes, we are heading to the end of the event.
Okay, all right. So I would like to thanks for everyone that joining us today, and I hope to see everyone again for the next our IAD Corner. So please keep update in our Facebook page, website, and also the student group live. We will inform you the next upcoming IAD Corner, which is maybe in the next month. And yeah, so what is our Facebook name again, nakha?
KKU International Students.
And also International Affairs Division. You can start to search by your smartphone now and typing on Facebook International Affairs Division, and you can update our event or activity. All right. Okay. So today, say thank you.
Thank you very much. We hope you learned a few new things. And before the next session, which will be, I think, in about 4 weeks.
Yeah, or so, in the next 4 weeks.
The idea is if there's anything you want to know, if there's any activity that you want to do, if you want to take some initiative or whatever, but you don't know how, let us know. Write it on Facebook. You can even contact us personally. And we will discuss that then in the next IAD corner.
Okay, thank you, the speaker, Nong Mewadi and Ms. Poonang again for joining us. And we are so happy and get a lot of, you know, experience from you. And I hope that our participant will happy and gain some new knowledge with us.
Okay, and we look forward to seeing you again in a few weeks from now.
Okay, so, bye-bye.
Until then,
bye-bye. Bye-bye, sawadee krap.
Adikap, thank you all.
Oh, leave, right? Or you can close.
I'm expecting everyone leave.
Who is still there? One is still there. The IAD people are still there. How many participants still?
We have 20.
Mon, Agung.
Only us.
Only us.
Bye bye. See you at the meeting room.